So we were discussing this decree for judicial separation. What is the need for this decree of judicial separation? If parties cannot live together, so what is the need for passing the decree for judicial separation instead of decree for divorce? The need is because law does not encourage the divorce. Law wants to have it a slower mode, and on going towards the divorce, the parties may get some cooling time so that they may rethink of having a decree for divorce, and their relationship might be saved. So law provided this judicial separation, decree of judicial separation, and grounds for this judicial separation are the same as those mentioned for the divorce. So if we talk in perspective of the grounds, on the same ground one can claim the decree for the judicial separation and one can claim the decree for the divorce. And if the one has claimed the decree of divorce, not the judicial separation, but court has power and the discretion to refuse the decree of divorce even when he has proved the quality ground for the divorce, and pass a decree of judicial separation. Why? The reason being just to cool down, and net result of this decree of judicial separation is that marital relationship is suspended. It is not annulled. It is not terminated. It is just suspended. And if for 1 year after passing of such decree, cohabitation does not start between the parties, then it will be the sole ground for the divorce. And a divorce can be granted on the ground that after the passing of the decree of the judicial separation, cohabitation has not started. So what the petitioner would require to prove? Only the decree of judicial separation. He has already proved in that proceeding the grounds for judicial separation or the divorce. So again he need not to prove all those grounds which he took in the judicial separation decree proceeding. Now here just to prove the decree, it is a documentary evidence, it can be proved by producing the decree and proving the fact that cohabitation has not started even after 1 year. Then on this ground the court can pass a decree for divorce. But no doubt the proceeding will have to take place in two phases. One proceeding for the judicial separation or the divorce, when the court, instead of granting divorce, grants the decree of judicial separation and the marital relationship is suspended for 1 year and it does not reshift, cohabitation does not start between the parties for 1 year, then it is a sufficient ground for the divorce. And if cohabitation starts between between the, this period, during this period of 1 year, though it is in violation of the decree for judicial separation, the parties have already been judicially separated, but it is no offense because they separated, but they never took divorce. Their marriage still subsists even after passing the decree for the judicial separation, and now they have again united, and they now don't need the divorce. But what will happen to that decree of judicial separation which has already been passed? That has to be rescinded, and section 10 clause 2 provides a remedy to address such a situation, to approach court and ask court, now we have started our cohabitation, we have normalized our marital relationship, so let this decree be rescinded, and court will rescind such decree. So approaching the court for rescission of such decree will not require filing a fresh suit. It may be done merely by producing a application or a petition, and this and in the same proceeding in which the judicial separation decree is passed, there is no need to proceed in a new and different manner. Now, coming to the most controversial issue of the most controversial part of a married life, that is a divorce. Law has made, especially Hindu law has made it very tough to get the divorce. A stringent procedure has been provided. So now you must know the grounds. What can be the grounds for the divorce? On what grounds one party can seek a divorce against other? Section 13 says, you must remember one thing, that in matrimonial disputes, especially under Hindu Marriage Act, the suit is not filed. It is the petition which is filed. So whenever you talk of a petition, of a proceeding, you should use the term petition, petitioner and the respondent, not the plaintiff defendant. What are the grounds? First ground, intercourse. After marriage, a party to the marriage has voluntary sexual intercourse other than his or her spouse. So extramarital intercourse, उसके बाहर जाके कोई इस तरह का हुआ है कृत्य, what would be the restriction? The restriction would be that such conduct has not been condoned and accused by the respondent. We discussed this very early कि इफ एनी ऑफेंडिंग कंडक्ट विच गिव्स राइज टू अ कॉज ऑफ एक्शन एंड इफ इट हैज बीन कंडोन बाय द अदर पार्टी और एक्यूज्ड बाय द अदर पार्टी सच पार्टी लूजेज हिज राइट एंड हिज राइट इज एक्सटिंग्विश्ड. सो फर्स्ट ग्राउंड इज द एक्स्ट्रा मैरिटल इंटरकोर्स. सेकेंड ग्राउंड इज क्रूअलिटी. Cruelty to the petitioner by the respondent. Case law has a wide amplitude of defining the term cruelty. It not only includes the physical cruelty but also includes the mental cruelty. We will come to discuss these points at length. We are just finishing it the grounds. So first is the extramarital intercourse. Second is the cruelty. Third is the desertion. If the petitioner If the respondent has deserted the petitioner for 2 years, for 2 years or more period, desertion has been made by one party. So desertion is a ground. Desertion means not living in the same house or there may be desertion. Both the parties are living in the one and same house, but there is no cohabitation, no relationship. We will deal it in detail. And next ground is the conversion. Cease to be a Hindu, has become Muslim. So it is a ground for the divorce, but the conversion itself is not ipso facto dissolve the marriage. What has to be done is that filing a petition for divorce on ground of the conversion. So a marriage can only be dissolved by passing a decree of nullity in case of void and voidable marriages. And by passing a decree of dissolution of the marriage, that is the decree of the divorce, where marriage is dissolved. And in case of passing a decree of nullity for void and voidable marriages, the marriage is annulled. Conversion. Next point is unsoundness of mind or mental disorders. If the nature of unsoundness or the mental disorders of one spouse is of such a nature that it cannot carry out the marital obligations, then it is certainly a ground for divorce. But if the parties are having the mental disorder, but disorder is not of the higher degree so as to create any obstacle in discharge of the marital obligation, then it cannot be a ground for the divorce. Next is the leprosy. Leprosy itself ground for divorce, but must be incurable form, virulent and incurable. Next is the venereal diseases, incommunicable form. Some venereal disease, one spouse is suffering and that is too communicable form. So keeping the relationship, arrive will have a risk of communication of such disease to the other spouse. Therefore, it is, has been a ground for the divorce. Renounce the world. साधु महात्मा हो गए हैं, ये अच्छा तरीका है। साधु महात्मा हो जाइए, डाइवोर्स का ग्राउंड बन गया। Has not been heard as alive for 7 years. Presumption of living being under Indian Evidence Act. Same has been incorporated here. Cannot been heard for 7 years. Though the presumption of law is in favor of the living, but if a person has not been heard of 7 years, then it will be a ground for divorce. Apart from it, additional grounds, these are the general grounds available to both the partners, and additional grounds, no resumption of cohabitation for 1 year after passing of the decree of judicial separation. No restitution of conjugal rights for a period of 1 year after passing a decree of restitution of conjugal rights. Decree of restitution of conjugal rights, when one party has left the association of the other, so other party can compel by a decree of restitution to restore back the company of the spouse. That is called the restitution of the conjugal rights. So on one hand, when a decree of divorce can be filed by one party, at the same time if other party is interested in the restitution of the conjugal right, may simultaneously file a petition for restitution of the conjugal rights. And in litigation in courts, in most of the cases you will find that one party has filed the divorce petition and other party files a petition for restitution of the conjugal right, so as to show his bona fides that he or she is more and more interested in the continuing the relationship, not in dissolving the relationship. These are the additional grounds available to the both. So what you have to do, you should note in your notes that what are the grounds available for a husband under section 13, or if you make this question broader, how can a husband get a decree of divorce under Hindu Marriage Act? So here you will mention 13 clause 1, all 5, 6, 7 grounds, plus 13 1A, additional grounds for decree of judicial separation and the restitution of the conjugal rights, and these all rights are also available to the female also, wife also. So up to here it is a common story, but now what are the additional grounds available to the female but not to the male, available to the wife not to the husband, to 13 clause 2, A wife may also present a petition for dissolution of her marriage by a decree of divorce on the ground husband had married again before commencement of this act, or any other wife husband married before such remarriage, bigamy.